Mysticism has a proper history. It has not evolved in 2 or 3 days. It has a proper history. The first time, the first period where we do have the criticism. Basically, when the literature started, criticism has started. Obvious thing.
It's an automatic
system. Automatic system. When someone used to tell some poem to me, so I'll be like reciting it in my mind. So it means when the literature got invented, on the same very time, the criticism has emerged. This point is clear? The history is the same. Now what the thing is, here we have few periods. Periods of criticism. Where the focus of the people have got changed from one topic to another topic. I told you criticism can be done in different ways. The same very pen, I can criticize it that how does it work. You can criticize it that how does it look like. The same thing is there. You are criticizing it in your own way. The topic has got changed. I am criticizing it on some other way. Point is clear?
Yes.
Okay. So in classical criticism, what was there? This was one era, one period. Here we find these two people, Aristotle and Plato. We will discuss them. Fine? After that we have medieval criticism. We will not discuss them. We will just touch them. Here the most focus was on the religion. Fine? So Boccaccio and Dante were the two of the critics over there. There were many more, but I am just giving you one or two names because it will become difficult for you to remember the names.
In a classic criticism, we were focusing on the art.
We will talk about that. No? Let me complete the history first. Then we have Renaissance criticism. Right? Renaissance period here, Philip Sidney is there. Still here, just focus on these very names. See the history, what the history is. Then we have Enlightenment criticism, rewriting, John Dryden is there. After that, Romantic criticism was there, William Wordsworth, George Keats, Coleridge, so many were there. I have given you only the name of William Wordsworth. Then we have New criticism, which now contemporary criticism, that is called the New criticism. T.S. Eliot is an example of it. Yes. But I wanted to tell you only for one thing, that you should know what is the history of criticism. So we are